with us this morning on this frigid Sunday morning. Didn't let the devil stop you. You made your way anyway. I believe God got a special blessing for you. Good to see you all here today. I want to call your attention. I don't think you have any first-time guests this morning. But I want to call your attention to all of the announcements that's printed in our newsletter. There is one that's not. We are fortunate enough to be one of three churches in our diocese to host a simulcast of Trinity Institute 2016 Sacred Conversations for Racial Justice. That will be held here at the church January 21st through 23rd. The main forum is held in New York City. But we will have a satellite location here at the church. There will also be a chance for interaction as well. Racial justice is a matter of life or death. We can't afford to stay silent and accept the invisible systems that support inequality. Rather, we need to have an open dialogue, which starts with listening. So Trinity Institute 2016 will be an opportunity for you to have life-giving conversations about the racial issues of our time, including structural racism, mass incarceration, and policy change. So come out on those 3 days, 21, 22, and 23 of January. Further information will be forthcoming as far as specifics about times, but come out and avail yourself of that opportunity to participate in this conversation that is really a worldwide conversation, not just nationwide, but we will be a part of that. We're fortunate to be one of those sites. Don't forget, vestry members, that vestry meeting is this Thursday at 6:30 p.m. If you cannot make it to vestry meeting in person, please see the information about calling in, which is printed in your newsletter. Also coming up this Saturday will be our next Concerned Black Episcopalians Forum. There is a flyer that is printed in your bulletin on page 22. It'll be a continuing conversation, and this time we'll be asking the question, what do we want? The first question that we asked was, are we dead? The first two sessions were dedicated to that. And this question now is, what do we want? And I think that the importance of these discussions is that we really got to get to the root of what the issues are, as opposed to jumping to solutions, as we've done so often in the past, going to try to form strategies when you don't really understand what the strategy should be. So this is really about kind of getting at the issues and helping to understand who we are and where we are. We had wonderful participation the first two sessions, and we expect this next session to be a great forum as well. Churches, African-American churches from around the diocese participate in this forum and are very excited about this format. So please come out on this Saturday from 9:30 to 12. Still taking vestry nominations. If you want to be on the vestry, you can let me know. Annual parish meeting is going to be Saturday, January 24th in the Guild Hall. And to that end, all guilds and organizations, we need to have your reports in by January the 15th. So please send them in by that time so that we can have time to compile our book. Are there any other announcements that need to be made out loud today? Most of you may have gotten the call that I sent out last night announcing the death of Brooklyn Nicole Cooper, the 7-year-old granddaughter of Charles Nightingale. Her funeral will be this Saturday, January 16th, at Arnett Chapel, AMU Church. The address, I forget what the address is, on South Bishop Street. And the visitation is from 10 to 11, and the funeral is from 11 until noon with interment at Washington Memorial Gardens. So please keep the Nightingale family in your prayers in this very, very difficult time. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace, and that light perpetual shine upon her forever. Any other announcements need to be